Eric Bakker, the naturopath. Thanks for coming back. Is there a link between SIBO, small intestinal bowel, you know, overgrowth, and a sinus infection? That's a very interesting question. And there's no easy answer for that question either. But I can tell you this, most people I've seen with bad sinus problems, especially real bad sinus problems, generally had problems with their gut. So I don't know why this is, but I've certainly seen the link there, and I know that by fixing up the gut and improving it, you can really help fix up the sinus a lot. It could have to do with the vagus nerve connection, the parasympathetic nerve connection between the small bowel and the digestive organs and parts of the brain. It could be that. But there are, you know, there could be different reasons why people are more prone to getting sinus when they have got a small intestinal bowel problem. Because if you think carefully about it, the small intestine is really the powerhouse for the body's immune system. It's the powerhouse. So once we start getting a problem with bacterial fermentation, with poor bacterial fermentation, you know, shunting a person into constipation or diarrhea or irritable bowel syndrome, we start messing up their immune system. We make them more susceptible. We make them more prone to getting different types of infectious diseases, including sinusitis, which is a shocking condition to have, particularly if it's chronic and protracted and drawn out. I'm certain I've made some videos on sinus on this channel. If you go and have a look, you'll find. I would say there is some type of link there, and it'll all come out down the track. It'll all come out through studies and research that when the small bowel's messed up, many parts of the body are messed up. So in time, well down the track, years from now, this gut will be seen as the most important part of the entire body, probably more important than anything we've ever realized. So by ameliorating and mending, repairing this intestine, we're going to mend nearly every part of the body. And if you look at Asian philosophy, they've always said that health starts from the gut. It radiates out to the rest of the body. And then, of course, we've had famous Western doctors, you know, jump on the bandwagon and say, you know, all diseases start in the colon. I think, but Asians have known this for thousands of years. This needs fixing up. When it is, most of the other things take care of themselves. Thanks for tuning in.